Yes, good evening everyone. Even today you are going to create your own blog just by using Django and Bootstrap. Even though you don't have any background knowledge on it, you'll be able to build your own blog, and to that you can make your custom things. You can buy domain and you can host it, and we can see, we'll add some more things. Right, so today's session is all about creating blog using Django and Bootstrap. I'll let you know what is Django and what is Bootstrap. You may be having idea or you may not have, but let me make it clear. First, the prerequisite is you just install Sublime Text. Go to browser and install Sublime Text. Because that is the very sophisticated text editor. If you are using Windows, then just download for Windows. That's it. No need to add path or anything. The reason I'm using Sublime Text is, which is something like very easy markup. It is used for markup languages, or it can be HTML, CSS, or PHP, or JavaScript. Even we can write our Python code, you can save it as Python format. You just install the Sublime Text. Then I'll let you know what are the packages which we are going to use, and what is Django, and how that differs from Flask, and why we are using today. For today's session. So basically Sublime Text is the best used text editor where you can go for markup language and programming languages. Then why we are using it for Python? See, for Python you can go for Python IDEs, or you can go for Sublime Text, Visual Studio, IDLE, the basic Python editor, and you can use PyCharm. Then why am I using Sublime Text for today's session? Because the only simple reason is I want you to make aware of different softwares, because from the past week from the different sessions, we are using our own command prompt to create a simple notepad file with the help of notepad command. You can create your Python file, Java file, text file, anything with the help of notepad command. Probably many of you may not be aware of that. So I'm trying to make you come out of the basic simple concept. See, the question is something like, how it differs from other backend programming languages, PHP and Node.js, because see, PHP you can use for many web applications. The only advantage of Python is it's an open source programming language. It's an open source platform where you can have any kind of packages. That packages can be related to web development or architecture or games or data. See, that is the reason Python is an essential or very easiest programming language where you can relate that thing to data analytics, database, and data science. That is the reason we are using Python. And I want to make sure we'll be using Django framework. I'll let you know what is the difference between Django and Flask, because some of you may have gotten previous sessions, we have already built a chatbot using Flask. But today we are going to use the other known, pretty comfortable and very much automatic generated web framework and the popular web framework of 21st century, Django. It is not new, but it is old, where you can have automatic creation of admin panels. Where you said if you go for PHP and CSS, PHP, you need to create an admin panel. Suppose if you go for any Facebook or Amazon, you see, right? We have all these fields, right? These fields do update every time. See, now we are getting back on track. That means this is quarantine period. They are not accepting orders. They accept only some kind of very important orders. That means they usually update it from backend. So in Django, our backend admin panel gets created automatically, and it supports many database management software, that is relational softwares, which includes SQLite, PostgreSQL, SQLite, MySQL. Yes, the code which we are going to write itself is Python code, because we'll be using some datetime library, which I have discussed in the previous webinar, where we have built a chatbot, where we'll be using datetime library. So for that, I need to have some Python, right? So that's how, mainly for simple operations, which include creation of complex databases. Yes, it is faster than Laravel. If you see, the best example is Pinterest and Instagram, which is purely built in Django. If you go for Netflix and other things, they are built in Flask. The main difference between Flask and Django is that, see, for Flask, you can have developer interest. Suppose I'm a developer, I wanted to make sure that I'll be using I'll be using some kind of application. I want to host it. I want to create authorization, where to host and how to host. Flask helps a lot because Flask came after Django from 2010. Django was initially developed from 2003 itself. It got licensed from 2005 and 2008. The foundation was formed and it has the biggest community where you can have supporting queries. People get contacted to you. You can ask them queries because it's an open source platform. Even for Python, you can go for PyPI. Yes, so this is the official Python community. I hope you can see the screen, right? By today, we are having 227,655 projects. That means they are having the packages, nearly those many packages. That's the reason if you use Python IDLE, you can have only built-in packages. But if you use Anaconda platform or other than Python IDLE, you can directly have them, something like NumPy, Pandas, related to data analytics and data science. So you can also use PyCharm for Python. But what we suggest is for a beginner, we start going from IDE, Integrated Development Environment. That's the reason where I use Python IDLE. But for today's session, we are going to use Sublime Text because where we're also using the most popular CSS and the most usable framework of 21st century, which is Bootstrap. Where you'll have automatic response. That means that web page which you created will be a response. We'll be having it in localhost. Because we need to have server and we need to use all those things, right? We may probably plan some other time. We may also use it. So in today's session, we'll be using Django and Bootstrap. We'll be installing only two packages, Django and Pillow. Because I hope you know what they mean by blog, right? Most of us know blogs, right? Some people may write blogs related towards it. They maintain those information about those people. So that's where we are using to create. Python Anywhere, actually in the last week, we had a session automating daily life with Python. We may plan some other day. We'll try to do it based on the requests and based on the niche technologies. Right, so that's the difference of Python, where you same Django and Flask. In Django, automatic creation of websites, databases, where in Flask you cannot have it. So these same CRUD operations, because Django and Python are both frameworks. So Django and Flask both are frameworks, where Flask is a lightweight framework, Django is a macro based framework. That means macro in the sense it can accept huge amount of data. Where you have same this CRUD operations, create, read, update, delete, those are same. No issues, you don't need any background knowledge of Bootstrap because the thing which we are going to do is use very smart thing. You'll be surprised with that thing. I may not call that thing as a wrong thing because a technical guy who is working towards a learning technology kind of programming languages or any kind of frameworks need to have very smart thinking and he should not repeat the work. Do not repeat yourself. That's the main motive of Django itself. If you refer Django links and Django documentation, they say the same thing. So, right, I'll be telling the database which we're going to use is SQLite because automatic creation of SQLite will happen. Yes, am I clear why we're going to use Django and Flask? Because we already have the session on Django, on Flask. Now we are going to have on Django. Let's go to the things. Yep. So open your command prompt. I hope you have Python in your system, right? If you don't have, you need to install it. Sublime Text is for comparing your whatever the code I share you, that's the boilerplate code, which is the base form of all the applications which we are going to use. In that, we'll be dumping all our files and we'll write from the scratch. Just command prompt. Yes, Python IDLE is fine, but you should have path set to your command prompt. We need to install two packages, Django and Pillow. So Django is the web framework and Pillow is for, because when we create a blog, we need to have our images, right? We'll upload the images. So to appear your images on the browser, we need to install a supporting library called as Pillow. Let's go for it. Just you need to install the packages. That's it. I already have the packages. So I'll just show you. You can directly install it. Pip install Django. See, I already have requirement already satisfied. If you see, it is installing two other packages called as SQL Parse and ASGIREF. So PyTZ is for Python time zone. If you have attended our previous webinars, we already used that thing for building a chatbot, and we also used in stopwatch. So PyTZ is for Python time zone, and SQL Parse is for storing models in our database, which we are going to use SQLite, which is a lightweight database. And ASGIREF, ASGIREF is for asynchronous server gateway interface, because we'll be communicating to, because framework itself is a taken from response from client to server end. And mainly Django follows MVT architecture, model, view, templates. That's the main architecture which is being followed by Django. The other frameworks, they use MVC, model, view, control architecture. The simple definition of model, view, and template is, if you go for models, whatever the fields which we are filling, right? We give the title block, we give out the description and everything for blocks, right? That's where we build up models. And view is something like whatever the logic we are writing, which the user will see. That can be CSS or JavaScript. Templates is nothing but the design format. How do we design? That can include HTML, right? So models, views, and templates. These are the main three components of Django framework. So is the installation done? Asgres is for synchronous web interface. That's a gateway. Hope you understand my point. Yep. So the next thing is pip install pillow. Pip install pillow. Pillow is for giving out the images. See, I have already requirement satisfied. Even I'm using Anaconda, but the thing is the path should be set to command prompt. Hope you understand my point. Don't get confused with that. Just it should, your command prompt should recognize. Now let's open wherever you can check. You can check in your command prompt, or you can check in your Jupyter Spider. I'm just checking a Python Django version. I'll show you. That's it. You may use your command prompt, or you may use your Jupyter or anything. I'm going to just show you the version of Django. Yes. Hope you can see it right. Log only means uploading the images and writing about us, right? What do you mean about the Excel sheet for a blog? I hope that doesn't add values to it. Python hyphen M, because the mode of it, Django double hyphen version. Just check it out. It will give you the version of 3.0.5. To check the version of, no issues, you can have Django. That's it. 3.0.5, if you install now, you get the new version, and that is fine. Next, let's create the first simple application using Django. Django hyphen. If you want, you can go to desktop and you can create where your file will be visible. CD desktop, because we'll be creating a simple Django application. You'll see how Django differs from Flask. I wanted to show you with this simple application. We can move your path to desktop. We'll only go with command prompt, and because we'll only go with command prompt, because I want to make sure how better we can use our command prompt. If you don't know that thing, then what is the need of installing all other softwares, Visual Studio, Anaconda? You should know how your command prompt is working first. So that is our main motive. Just change your directory to come desktop, cd space desktop. Then to create a simple Django application, Django, Django hyphen admin space start project space new and press enter. New is the project name. Start project, whatever the project you are creating, because Django will default creates manage files and it will create all the files. You can go to desktop and I can show you. See a folder created. Yes. Can you open the file? Can you open the folder? You can see manage.py, that is automatically created. See, default settings will be loaded. If you're not having Django, you'll get this error. Could not import Django. Are you sure it is installed? Just go to command prompt and make sure you set path to desktop, because you can see in desktop, we just run the file. Python, go for the folder. Yes, you can go to that folder. Folder location and just type Python space tab. You can find out manage.py, run the server, R-U-N-S-E-R-V-E-R, because you have automatically files created. If you can see in new folder, you'll be having settings, URLs, and the server file, ASGI file, which holds the database. You'll be having all the files. What I want is just to make sure why Django is automatically used for creation of any complex websites, and why it is of highly demanded, and why people of full stack developers are still in demand. When you click enter, you can see the server running. Hope you are following, right? You can copy your URL. Yes, you can see the URL 127.0.0.1:8000. If you go for Flask, it is 1:5000. But if you are using Django, right, that's a local host, you can copy the URL and you can paste it in the browser. See, you can see a rocket flying, right? That means you have successfully created simple Django project. For this, we'll add our three components: models, views, templates, that can be related to blogs, e-commerce, video streaming, any kind of even ERP or anything, because this is starting from the scratch. So now I'll share you a boilerplate code. You just run your command prompt. See, it is telling not added favicons and everything, because we did not add anything towards it. We did not add any settings because we did not create any model. It will show us the same thing because we have just make use of run the server with the help of manage.py. Because in manage.py is a simple application where if your Django is working perfectly, it will show you a simple rocket flying where you need to add fuel towards it. That fuel is MVT, model, view, templates. Yes, I'll be sharing a tiny URL where I'll be sharing a boilerplate code. This boilerplate code, yes, that's where we add favicons and everything. I'll share a boilerplate code which includes the files where we need to write code from the scratch. You just download it, the boilerplate code, which is the base for your application, where we'll build our blog by creating models, views, templates, and we'll have our backend admin form, which is very simple in Django. But if you go for CSS and if you go for PHP and Java, where creating an admin panel is hectic, that's why Python is considered as this. Django is considered as the best web framework of 21st century. Python, Django, Flask, right? You just download it, the boilerplate. And if you're having Sublime Text, you just open that thing in Sublime Text. Let me go for a desktop. You can add anywhere your interest. Yeah, I may be having some other names. Yes, did you download it, everyone? The reason for giving you the boilerplate code is that's a base code where you start building your applications. We need not waste much more time. Just open your Sublime Text and extract the folder and open that folder. Select that folder and open in Sublime Text. That's it. So hope you have opened your Sublime Text. Then just go to command prompt. Then what is your folder name? Or it is very simple. You just go to your location where your folder is, because we need to start simple application. What is the file name I gave? Django boilerplate, right? I'm going to tell you a very simple shortcut. Probably you may or may not know. Yes, Sublime Text is recommended, where you open your file folders in that location. See, you just type cmd and press enter. You get the command prompt. Yes, you got the command prompt with the location where you're having path set to Django boilerplate. I need to create my application. What is my application? Blog, right? Python manage.py, where someone said now we are using start application. And you can give out any name. Don't think whatever the name I'm giving you should give, but I'm relating to this blog. It executes and you can see. Go to the folder and open in command prompt you can see a folder created called as blog, where you'll be having these models automatically created, MVT, models, views, and you can come back and you can see the templates which we have given. Then open Sublime Text. Yes, can you see the blog folder here now? Just open Sublime Text and I think you can see the blog folder, admin, apps, models, where you are going to create models, views. Yes, just what you need to open is, you can see my site and you can go for settings. Can you spot out the settings .py file? Can you see the 33rd line? Installed apps. So there you just press enter and tap. You need to add your blog towards it in quotations. Quotations open, add your blog folder towards it and comma. That's it. Because we have added a blog folder, and in the Django settings, it should take that you have created a blog application where you start writing your MVT architecture. Models, views, templates. Don't change anything in the manage.py because it is automatically created in Django, because Django itself is for automatic creation of complex applications. So then you can see in migrations, you can go for models and we start writing our models here. But before that, see, we have already from Django.db import models. It is taking default and you now start writing here from django.utils, you need to import time zone because our blog will also have time whenever it is published. And you wonder, you have a like button over there. It is very much responsive where we use our Bootstrap. You can click number of times. You click as you like it. Yes, from django.utils, you need to add this in models, because models is where we create our data. You don't add anywhere, you just follow my instructions, then you're going to create your blog. Now, you can see here, it shows create your models here. That's where you start writing your program. We create a class, because Python is an object-oriented programming language, Django uses complete classes concept. Even if you're trying to build an e-commerce application, or a banking application, or an ERP, or a simple blog, everything should be in the format of classes, because that has its own property, right? Now we are going to build a model where you have a text field, you have a character field, where you have date time field, where you can upload images, where you can have like button. With the name post, make sure whatever the class name you create, you're good to go with that. Models.model, where I'll be creating a object called as models. My class name is post, where I'll be giving my parameters called as title, because my blog will have title, models dot, which has the character field because it will have a rectangular box. You can give out maximum length as it is, that's your interest. I suggest to give the simple thing, that is for title. And next thing is for, generally blogs will have title, description, and when it is published and what is the image. Our motive is to make you understand the simple things. Models dot text field for your blog, that is for description, and this is where we use our timestamp. Timestamp with models dot, don't worry, I'll be explaining it every field once again. Just go for it. Once you have created all the fields, the color is going to change to blue color. And the default is, I hope you remember now method in time libraries, right? Import date time, which we have used for building chatbot application. We'll be using the same concept here. Time zone dot now. And for image, I create another parameter and assign models dot image field, models, M-O-D-E-L-S, I think my screen is visible, right? Hope everyone can see it clearly. That's the reason I'm using Sublime Text. You can see it colorful. Models.image field and where we need to upload. Because we'll be having an automatic dynamic admin panel created where you can post your title and post your images and everything. Then for likes, see, if you are gonna mesmerize with the help of like button, for sure I can guarantee you, because the logic which we have used is a very pretty simple Python logic. You'll be surprised with that. Default is zero because the likes is the default, because at the creating we don't have any like for our blog. When a person clicks, it will automatically update. Then you call the class, define str with the help of self method, and you call it and return the title, because whenever a person checks the title of the blog, it should return to admin panel. So for that, you have created models. This is a simple model. So make sure you give out the space. Don't worry about the spaces, because you'll be getting the errors. I've shared you the code. Define double underscore str double underscore, because double underscore plays a very key role in Python. You just go to admin.py. See here, default you have from django.contrib import admin. It should take admin, because that's how automatically it is created, where we have, when we create a new project, Django automatically creates where you can add your models, views and templates. Now here, you just take the class. What is your class name? You can see in models, what is your class name? Post. You just take from it. From django.models, import post. Sorry, from my mistake, my name is blog, right? Not Django. Admin dot, that means you are creating an automatic admin panel, because it is very simple in Django. But if you go for PHP and Java, that becomes hefty thing. Admin dot site dot register post. Just two lines of simple things. You go to the folder where you are running, or you can go to the command prompt. Simple thing is, you just go to the folder where you have extracted the boilerplate code which I have sent you. You just go to the folder. It's better, instead of going everywhere, you just go to the folder and type cmd in the search bar. Yes, write as I do, python space manage.py. Run the manage.py, because why I'm doing here, if you go for directories, if you click it, you can see what are the directories you have present. My site, static folder, templates. Can you see the blog folder? I think you can spot the blog folder over there. That is the reason I'm trying to tell you why you should go to the same folder. You just go to the same location and now go for python space. Everything is done with manage file, manage.py, because we are managing it. Then we created a model, right? For every model creation, you need to migrate the data. What do you mean by migrate? Take from. Your Django should understand that you are creating a model. It should take the model. So just go for make migrations. No spaces. If you write space, you are obviously going to get into an error. You just press enter. You can see migrations for blog, create model post. That means the migrations are done, applied. Can you see it? Migrations means, what do you mean by, see, I often suggest my students or whoever the people working, you just think Python as an English language. What do you mean by migration? Character field, C capital, F capital. Because I said case sensitive, Python is case sensitive programming language. Migration, to migrate something, to locate from one place to another place, right? That's how whatever the fields you are, yes, exactly. You created a model, you migrate it. Then the next step is you just migrate the data. Python, same, manage.py, migrate. Because whenever you change everything in model, every time you need to migrate. Now, why do we are doing migrate means we have a tables created in our database. That means an SQLite folder will be created. In settings.py, just we have created the blog. We'll add it in the installed apps. That I'm starting it from the beginning itself. Please try to follow it because I'm also already into the session. See, applying all migrations to admin, authorization, blog, content type, sessions, you can see everything is perfect. These are not errors. Whatever the authorizations you are trying to made are applied on your blog. Don't go out of any folder. Just stay here. Python, manage.py, create super user, because super user is the admin where he can add the content. Even if you go for Netflix or Instagram, anything, you have the admin panel because they'll be uploading movies, posts and everything to the website. Create super user, no space towards it. You just follow. See, username, give out your username. Make sure you remember the username. So I suggest I'll go for root, which is similar to SQL. I define my username as root. You can give out your username as it is, but make sure you remember it. Username as root. I give my mail ID. That's my mail ID actually. Make sure you give your password, very simple, because you are trying to connect to that admin panel. Make sure you remember the password. It will ask for the password again. See, this password is too common. Just go for it. Click yes. Super user is automatically created. That's how you can get the admin panel, and I'll show you. Yes, is it done? Python manage.py, create super user. Because you are creating an admin panel, just make sure you remember the username, because once you forget the username, we cannot do anything. And also password, no forgot password guys from here, because that's the thing we usually do. Then just go for Python manage.py, run server, run the server. See, just copy the same URL. Slash, you need to type admin, not 127.0.0.1. Can you spot the page? 127.0.0.1 is to, yes. If you type 127.0. Because we did not apply any changes, right? We have created just an admin panel. Slash admin. Username, you open the username and give out the password credentials and login. Guys, no forget password here. We just log in. See, your admin panel is ready. I think, can you spot it out, right? You can see the post here. You can click on it. You can add the post. So it is not yet done because we have just created admin panel where we'll have all the functionalities now. So this is actually your character field. This is your text field. This is your time field. This is your image field. That's what I gave you. And see the likes field. These are the fields which we have created in admin pan models.py. You can write your own description. Welcome to webinar. And if you see, the date is correct in the format of year, month and day, but you can see the time is wrong, right? Can you see the time is wrong, right? In settings.py. See, someone asked me from the beginning, observe, you can check it out here. You just add blog here because we are creating a blog. Yes, Jen, scroll down. You can see the time zone. It is UTC. change it to Asia hyphen Kolkata. Asia slash Kolkata, because this is the time zone which I have already made use in, where we have done a simple application by building chatbot and stopwatch. I have used the same thing. You can add that thing in time zone. In settings.py, go to 109 line, add the time zone, Asia, Calcutta. Then go for save all and you can directly refresh the page. Now you can see the time is changed. Once you refresh, your content will be gone. Make sure you give out the clear content. The time is 7:18 now. You can see in 24-hour format. Can you see the change in time? Yes. You first run the server. Make sure you get you the slash admin. We'll be creating all the functionalities. First, let's upload the image file here. So you can choose file. I'll choose our company logo basically. Then you can save it. It is done. When you click it, you can see all the things. You can also have the delete option. Then see, that's the reason I gave you define double underscore str, right? So to see the title of your blog string format, it returns this object title. That's the reason I gave you. We have created a post, but we need to have the views, right? So to display our post, we need to have views because we need to see, right? Then open your Sublime text. Then go to views.py. Now start writing our views because it provides views. Basically, we have created a model because model is for data. And to retrieve the logic, I need to go for views because Django follows three components: models, views, and templates. First one is done. We are going in the middle of it. Views. Views is for creating our app logic. Yes. And you start writing your code here. From, I'll explain each and everything. From Django dot views dot generic, you need to import two types of views, basically list view and detail view. Detail view, these are built-in functionalities or built-in libraries in Django views package where we need to retrieve our blog in this format. I'll show you once we write, you'll understand why we are doing it. Then similarly, you take from blog.models, you import, what is your class? Post. Then to get the response, you go for from django.http response. What you need to import? What is your response? JSON response. Make sure you give this as it is because those are built in. This JSON response is for giving your like button. It should press and it should give out in the database. JSON response, J capital, R capital. Yes, is it done till here? Importing packages from django.views.generic, import list view and detail view to give out the views of your blog. We take the class which we have taken from models.py. Then for like button, we create the response. Views is something like the logic which we are writing to see the blog on the web page. Yep. Now create all the classes. You'll understand at the end why we are writing everything. For list view, you create a class called as post list. Because I'm writing with the simple English words so that you can understand. And what is your model? The class is post. Then the next class is, just go with the simple class concepts, post, detail, and what is the view? You can see the suggestions you are getting already because you have already imported it. And what is the model? Just follow your suggestions. Don't do anything other than that. Make sure you give out it in spaces. Now the logic which I'm going to write is for like button. See, this logic you'll understand when we create the like button and when we give the functionality, because I will tell you a simple thing. See, if you created a post on Instagram, you published it, your post is getting likes, right? Today, now at 7:25, you got 2 likes, and after 7:30, you'll be having 10 likes. 2 plus 8 likes, right? You'll be having the number of likes in increasing order. I'll define my simple functionality for likes, because we'll be, the code we write is very simple, because we are the Python programmers, we make it very simple. We give up the request method, request dot method. What is your response? It should take the response, that is get method. Then I'll explain once I write this, don't worry, you just go with it. Request dot get dot case sensitive, make sure you go for it, don't try to go in another way. I dot none, I comma none, p is equal to, what is your class? Post, not post details, post dot the objects which you give, objects dot get, what is your id? First initial id is equal to 1, and here it should update, p dot likes is equal to, id is equal to 1, because we initialize id is equal to I, because it states from the initial state which it takes from the user. When a user clicks, it should store in the database and it is the same thing. P dot likes, I use my simple assignment operators. If you are familiar with Python, you'll understand this assignment operator, incrementing operator, right? P dot likes equal to P dot likes plus 1, and save them in the database. Yes, whatever the data should be responded as JSON format. Data is equal to I colon, what is the data it should take? P dot likes. Then return the response. Make sure you write in the perfect logic. Return JSON response, J capital, R capital. JSON response of your data. Save them. You save this. Save all. Shall we go for it? I've already copied it. Now your VOC is done. Next, go to, you can go to urls.py, where you'll be navigating, because MVT architecture follows taking response from the template. Template is nothing but where you type the URL, right? Where you require the URL and your views should give the response, right? That's the MVT structure. Simple, you type for amazon.com. If the site is unavailable, you'll get 404 page found, right? You are asking for request, your server is giving you some response. So that is the reason in views I have given all the logic, and in URLs I'm trying to write the logic. Make sure you go to urls.py and add blocks over there. You change the path, you add the path again. Path, don't remove the above thing, you just add path. My routing is empty because I'm not adding anything. Don't give out any spaces, you just give him open quotation and close quotation, comma, and you include, what you should include? You should include blog.urls in quotations, and you close the brace and comma. Where, when you click 127.0.0.1:8000, it should navigate to blog. Yes, it should navigate to blog block. Exactly, I can say. Once it is done, you can save all. I hope it is clear, right? Then just go to your folder where you have opened the file and open click the blog folder, open CMD, because we don't have any URLs folder over there, URLs file. You go to your root folder and open blog, because blog is your project, right? You just click, see, you go to command prompt and open in this mode, notepad space urls.py, because I'll be using simple thing. I'll create every file with the help of notepad, because I have learned something from my tutor. Whenever I learned 5 years back, I'll make use of my command prompt. See, you'll get a suggestion box, click yes and close it. That's it. Yes. Now you can see in Sublime Text, don't run that thing. You can see the urls.py. See, now you can see the urls.py in blog folder. Now you write your code here to navigate that thing to the blog. See, my site URLs are different and blogs is different. Now you write entire script here, because we need to take the views from the blog, blog.views, your list of views, detail views, and you need to navigate them the like button. You just open it and you start writing code over there. From django.urls import path where we retrieve from Django, from blog.views, because we have already created views, right? So from this it should take the properties. Import post list comma post detail comma like we, what are the methods and classes which we have given, you need to make sure as it is. Views, you can see post list, post detail, like view. It will take all these properties into the URLs in your blog folder, blogs.py. Yep. Then what is your application name? Blog. So I define the same thing, blog. Then you root the URL pattern, because we are trying to root the patterns. URL patterns is equal to, you create in the format of list. Path, you can go for simple tab space or whatever it is, no issues. You create in the format of list. Path, make sure you give out your correct empty string, comma. You need to go for post list, it will give you suggestions. As underscore view, because how we are going to view it. And name it. Name is equal to, what is the name you want to give? Post hyphen list. You can name as it is, but if you want to change, you need to create such kind of HTML files. That's the reason we are giving here. And other path, for everything we create a path. So for list you can create, and here which post I can click, I should give the routing here. Detail integer, this is the logic I am writing for my, according to my SQLite, int hyphen pk, because primary key, it's not Pawan Kalyan or anything, it's primary key, because whenever you open specific post it should show you. Int pk slash, you open the slash and close it, and this is for details. Post detail dot as underscore view, it will give you the suggestion already, as view comma, and what is the name you are giving? Post hyphen detail, because list is already done, this is for the separate pages. Then this is for, because we are gonna use Ajax also here, for like button. Yep, Ajax hyphen likes, you need not have any background knowledge. Ajax hyphen likes, Ajax slash likes slash, because these are the URLs which we are migrating. and make sure whatever like view you define here, define over there, and what is the name you want to give for it? Like, these are the simple things where we give out in URL patterns. First one is post list, how you should view, and the next one is details view, where you create the details for separate thing, and the third one is for likes, because how you want to view, how the detail you should get, and what are the likes. You just click file, save all, Ajax is for like functionality, because whenever you click like button, you'll, for Instagram you get a pop-up symbol, right, heart shape. For Facebook you get a like thumbs up, right? So Ajax is asynchronous JSON script and XML markup language. So whenever you have your like button clicked, now run the server. You just go to the same location, Python manage.py, run server. You just copy the URL as it is. If it is already running, you can paste over there. See what you are getting over there? You'll get this. For sure you need to get this error. This time you should get error. Did you get this? When you run the server, Python manage.py run server, you should get this error. Template does not exist. Yes? Did you get this, everyone? We are gonna finish it up in next 15 minutes. It's about to wind up, where we'll be using our bootstrap thing here, because Django model views and templates. In templates, we are gonna use this. You can run the server in command prompt and you can see you need to get this. Now models are over, views are over, because here what is the error you are getting? Template is not existing. We need to create this template. That's what we are going to do now. The third component of Django. Now let's go to the folder, open command prompt. We have already this templates folder, right? Which I have shared you in boilerplate. Can you see the templates folder? We should create a templates where you have CSS and JavaScript. Since static, you're having all these things. It is clearly telling you in templates, you're already having a base file where you need to have this list, post list. Post list P capital L capital. So you go to templates folder and open it in command prompt. Yes. Now, when you go to templates folder, you need to create a folder called as blog. For that, mkdir blog, because you can see your error. What is the error? It is telling you blog/post_list.html is not present. You have template folder, you don't have blog folder in template folder. So in template folder, you need to create a blog folder and you need to have the post list. That's where we are going to use our bootstrap. You just go to the template folder, open it in command prompt like this, create a new directory called as mkdir blog. Then go to blog, cd space blog. Now notepad space post, what is the error you can see here? You can see in the browser, post_list. You just do the same thing, post_list.html, because now we'll be adding our template to this file. Yes, you close it, and now when you refresh the same web page, you can see the empty page, right? Once you create blog directory in templates folder, locate to blog folder and create notepad/post_list.html, and when you run your same server, you need not run again because it's automatically running. You just refresh the web page. That's it. You can see an empty page. Can you spot the empty page? Towards it. Go to Sublime Text. You can see. You can open with base HTML, right? In blog folder, you already have this base.html. Here we'll be adding our Bootstrap script. Though you should be very careful here because this is where you give your output. Just go open to go to Bootstrap. I think you know Bootstrap, right? It's a most popular making a responsive website. This is the 21st century open source HTML, CSS, and the JavaScript front-end web framework where you will have automatic responsive web pages. Yes, go to Bootstrap web page, getbootstrap.com. The only thing we use is the latest version CSS script. See, you need not install anything. I'll do the smart work. As I said, do not reinvent anything. You just copy the CSS script, go to the Sublime Text, paste it here. That's it. That is the CSS script. Make sure you paste the CSS script and then the JavaScript, because you are trying to give it the Bootstrap functionalities to your web page, your template is empty. Just copy this and paste it in the base.html. The spacing doesn't matter, but your code should look very neat. So make sure that this is aligned in a simple way. Right, just copy the CSS script and the CDN from the Bootstrap and the JavaScript. Then go to explore the docs, because you need to have your nav bar, right? Navigation bar. That means how you should have this navigation bar for your blog page. Then go to components to your left side. I'm telling you once again, just don't get confused. Main, explore the docs, set out your left side, click on components, search for nav bar, click on that. You just scroll down, you'll get mesmerized. The thing is, you can have different nav bars. That's the reason Bootstrap has been wide demand nowadays. You try to learn the functionalities from CSS and PHP, but you can have, if you scroll down, you can have different types of nav bars. So for my blog, I'll take the first one, which looks pretty simple and pretty good. This is my nav bar. I just copy the code and go to your Sublime Text and you paste it in the body. Yes. Then in nav bar, what is my application name? I change it to blog, and you can change this. You can change the link to about, wherever you have white color, you can change them. Home, about, and drop down is similar. See, the drop down is something like where you have, when you click that, you can get. So I want to add services to it. Just more 15 minutes, we are going to experience something. In services, what I want to add chat room. If you all attended chatbot webinar, you can add it to your own. You can add the chatbot program to a link here. I'll add forum and ping me. This is the simple things I'm trying to give out in navbar. And you can remove this disabled option. You can change all of them. Yes, you can make the changes directly here. Wherever you're having navbar, and wherever from navbar you start changing it, blog, and you can also add here sticky, STICKY, sticky / top. That's for making your navbar, whatever the blocks you may write, the navbar should be stick to your top position. Yes, I think it's done, right? You make your home, about, chat room. You can see the services, chat forum, chat room, forum, ping me. There are things you can change it over there. And search option is available for your web page. And if everything is done, you just paste the entire navbar code in the body tag. Then you go for post_list.html. Here you are going to write code. Curly braces, you need to extend the HTML logic. You try to follow it. I'll paste the entire code at the end. What you need to take the logic from base.html. Curly brace. I need to take the logic. So curly brace is a defined syntax where you need to write over here. And percentile block. So this curly brace is the defined syntax where you write in Django. So that is the reason where you are writing curly brace is nothing but this Django template language, because you are writing everything in templates. Yes, you just follow the thing. Curly brace, percentile block content, I'll be sharing you the thing. Then you add the tags here. What is your tags? This thing you are giving for your blog. How many rows and how many calls? Because in Bootstrap, the best advantage is if you can make sure your page should have 5 blocks or 3 blocks, 12 blocks. Simple, my page will have 2 blocks where I can define my columns. It takes define 12 columns, 12 by 6, 2 blocks. If you want 3 blocks, column 3. That's where I define you. Now next I'm going to write it. Same curly brace. Percentile for, see, I'm going to for loop. I'm going to use simple for loop for object_list percentile. This is the Java template language, Django template language, and that is for the row. This is for the columns. See, here I'm going to define column-6 because I want to have 2 blocks only in my first row. If you want to have more, if you want to have 3 number of rows, make sure that is divisible by 12. 12 by 6, 2 blocks. 12 by 4, 3 blocks. 12 by 3, 4 blocks. In a grid view, to make it very simple. Again, tag A, this is ID for your header where you are gonna create h_id, where I refer href is equal to curly brace percentile URL where you start these quotations. Make sure you give the quotations over there. I'll save the entire code in the chat box, but make sure you try to follow it. Blog detail, because this thing we are trying to give out the response to the web page where you are in the final stage of building Django architecture, the template stage. I.id percentage, how many number of likes you are going to experience. Then curly brace again, I.title again, tag open, then /a where you are gonna give out some spaces. I think you know br, right? For spaces. Then i.title, you can see that you can go for the next line where you can understand when we build the page. Percentile i, that is for blogs. Now we'll write the logic for images. See, backend is done. The front end part is remaining, because the simple thing is you are going to create your own website today. And you take the source and how that should store. i.image.url and this curly brace close. It should take the reference. Alt is equal to. It should take whenever we upload a post. Take from that. And you can go for normal resolution of the image. I give 300x300, height is 300 and width is 300. You can go for it, your wish. based on your usage, based on your image size, you can change it. Then end the blocks, end the if block, and end the for block. This is the template language. End if. We can also use end if in Python to close the blocks. Close the braces with the spaces. I do give br for the next line, right? If you have some basic knowledge on that, then you understood that why we are using br tag, and I close the div tag because I have started it and I need to close it. That's the advantage of Sublime Text here. That's the reason, considering all the time factors, we do tell this thing, see div tag, and then close the end block. We have initialized it and we need to close it. Yes, you just save it base.html. See, I cannot send the entire code. I said you just copy from the Bootstrap website. In the head tag, you just copy the CSS and JavaScript. In the body tag, you just go to Bootstrap components and go to navbar and select your navbar type, and you can copy the entire thing. Yes, now you should make sure you save all the things, and we can see, so it's already running. Then you can save it. See, you may not get the color. If you want to experience it in a better way, because Google will store the caches, you can go to Edge, Microsoft Edge, and you can run the same. I think you'll not get the color. Make sure you don't get the color. Yes, did you get this? Let me show you once. Let's clear the. I'll rerun the code again. 0.0.1:8000. It's refreshing. Can you spot the page? But when you go for click on hello, you can see the template. This doesn't exist. Yes, how many of you did not get? We are going to add this. We are going to do this thing now. Did you get this page? Whenever you refresh, you'll get the home page. How many of you have got that page? Template blog/post_detail does not exist. That's what we are going to create now. Same, go to the file where you have opened. So this is my folder. I go to templates, open command prompt. So go to blog, same, open command prompt. That's a simple thing. Notepad, post, I think it's post, yes, post_detdetNow a HTML will be created over there. You just close it. Now you refresh it. See, it's an empty web page, right? Now you add content towards it. If you can see in blog, you have an empty post_detail.html page. Yes, can you see it? You write the Django template language. I'll save this code where we need to extend it from the base. If you don't make changes in the base file, you don't get the web page. Make sure you do it. base.html percentile. Just next 10-15 minutes, we are going to wind up. We are in the last thing of creating the template detail. Blog content percentile, and you give out the h references for IDs. ID is equal to h_id, close the tag, and you give out the response, because whenever we click our first post, it should respond to the title, right? So object.title, and you close the tags. Automatically Sublime Text will create you. Yes, next for the paragraph tag, p id is equal to the text. B text is for CSS, where we add for JavaScript and CSS, where we are going to add at the end, I can also show you the web page color. You can add some web page entire color, because we are going to create not a simple thing in this. We are going to add everything, the front end and the back end. And you close the p tag, paragraph tag, and close the spaces with the both the tags br, and then button, because br is for break, right? So my button should function. What is my button? Button type, my class button. You can also give out some bootstrap thing here. We can add the color towards it also. It may take nearly just 10 minutes. On click, see, on click is the functionality where I am giving, because when you click it, it should respond, right? On click, and what is the function you are writing? Capital C, on click. Make sure you write the difference here, because this adds much more thing. What is the button you are creating? Because this thing is pretty much simple in Bootstrap. We are writing that responsibility for Bootstrap. Like button. And what is the tag you are giving? Paragraph tag. And what is your ID? ID is like. We are just at the end of the thing, because I wanted you to understand how simple Django and Bootstrap works, because we need to add the like button and we need to give out the functionality for it. P tag, and whatever the thing you can write, how where your blog is published. You have already changed the time zone, right? Blog. Published on according to the object.timestamp, because it should take the present time. Yes. Next three more lines, we are going to end it. I'll share the same thing here. Import ID is equal to, because it should take the syntax from likes ID. Likes ID, that is, what is the type you are giving? Type is equal to hidden. And what is the name you are giving to it? Name, because we are writing the functionality for our like button. And if you want the colors for it, you can take it from simple again. Our smart work is take it from the Bootstrap website, bootstrap.components. See, we are not making something like copy paste thing. We are trying to make sure how simple Bootstrap works it out. You can go for any kind of application, and you can go for any responsive web pages. You can go for it. Then go to Bootstrap. In the Bootstrap, you can see, is it done? Can we run that? Let me, yes. Yeah. That's a typo error. Yeah. I might have get in the errors, because I can debug it, no issues. If you are good at that thing, then you can solve it. Yeah. Thanks for intimating. Save all. Then you again refresh the web page. Yes, can you see it here? Hello, welcome to webinar. You have it, and when you click it, it doesn't have any functionality, because that's where you give out your like button functionality, where we have come towards end of it. Can you get this web page? Whatever the content you gave, your description, your like, and you can see, you can refresh the web page, and your timestamp works it out accordingly. You can change that in time zone. When we posted, the time zone is, see, the this blog is posted on April 12 and at time 7:18, but my like functionality is not working, right? Just go to your HTML, your Sublime text, and go to your JavaScript. In static, you can have CSS, images, JavaScript. Images for storing the images. In JavaScript functionality, script.js, you write your query. You run the server, you have your blog, click on the title of the blog, you get the description, but like button is not functioning. Now we write the functionality for like button. What is your function on click which you have created? And write the logic for it. Variable I is equal to, it should take from the document by get element by ID, because if my blog is one, it should take the first blog. If it is second blog, get element ID, because the blogs may differ and the likes may differ. So it should take for every blog and it should store the value in the database so that whenever you can see your blog, you can get it. So as JavaScript, as I already said in the previous webinars, you can go for dollar symbol, dollar dot Ajax. And what is your URL? Because you're trying to give it in the format of JSON. Yes. Slash Ajax slash likes slash, because it should navigate, that like button should functionality, and it should take the data from which we have created in models. You can observe for everything you need to give out comma, and this is the JSON script data. It should take the data from the models which we have created, the like functionality. You can see the models.py. This where I refers to this I, because whenever you click one like, it should navigate, it should update over there. When you click second like, it should update in the database and it should be visible to you. Then what is the data type? JSON format. Make sure you give it in the format of dictionary, key and value. And what is the functionality it should give you? Success. Success function. We are about the end, don't worry. And if you want to train on such kind of things, we are also providing internship in web development by Django. Coming Wednesday, we are about to start the batches. And most of the people from WIT, SRM, LBRC, you are attending the session, they are also going to join on this. If you are interested in getting out such things, you can ping us for internships. I'll give out the details at the end. Yes, is it done? You just run the web page again. If it, I have already pasted the code in the chat box. You can check it out. You just run the web page, refresh it, and you click on like. You may not get the functionality. What you need to do, either open in another Edge browser or clear the cache, because Ajax, this Google stores always the cache. So your Ajax functionality may not be applied over there. That doesn't mean your function is wrong. You just clear the cache. You just refresh the web page. Yes, you get the functionality. You can see over there. Now you can click number of likes. One like, two like, three like, four like. It's your interest. Whether you go for 127 dot, you have your image. This is your title. You click on hello. Your blog is created. You have 5 likes and now you like the blog. Yes, did you get the like functionality? If you are not getting the like functionality, clear your cache. Please clear your cache and run the file again. Yes, did anyone get this thing? We are about to wind up. That's how your blog is created. If you want, if you are interested in such kind of things, we are also providing internship in Django. You can also post another blog. How I do, I just go to slash admin 127 dot, I go for slash admin, I give out my password, root, and I give out my password. You can click on post, you can click add another post, new. I have created a blog. You can see the time zone 8:25 exactly, and I want to give another image, same my code name image, and I save it. You can open 127 dot. See, you can see two blogs in the page. with the name hello and with the name new. Can you spot it out? You need to clear your cache. Please clear your cache. When you click on new, see your likes functionality working. Yep. If you click on home, see it will show only slash because your home functionality is not working. Then you need to go for Sublime Text, go to post list and copy this entire URL and paste it in base.html. Where you need to paste, scroll down and in this hreference. Yes, you just paste the I'll tell you once again, you can save it. You just go to post list, copy the hreference because it should go to the home page, right? Go to base.html and go to line 24 and copy the same thing and remove the IDs. You make post hyphen list and you save them, save all, and you can, when you run it, can go to home. See, when you click, your likes are updating. You can go to home. See, if you want to add functionality for about on services, you can build your own things. You can also give out videos, anything by adding video tags in your HTML pages. So this is how we have created our blog.